This episode is brought to you by Pulsar.
I always grew up listening to Nepali music. So he said that I was not conscious about it. Mm. You know what I mean? Father's playing.
Baba, yeah.
Playing, Narayan Gopal's playing everywhere. Ombikam Bishta. It was playing everywhere. It's just that I had not sort of was not conscious about it because I thought that was not cool. Mm. Father's playing, someone's playing. So when I sort of got into actually writing a Nepali song and all that, so things just came so natural to me. Like,
which one was the first one that you wrote?
Wildfire.
Wildfire was the first one that you wrote?
First one.
When was this?
2013.
2013?
Yeah.
That was the first one you wrote.
Yeah. So this happened after I...
All of us know Syndicate. I know.
Syndicate happened after the sketches of Darjeeling.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
र इन्ट्रेस्टिङली लाइक मैले त्यो भन्दाखेरि चाहिँ सो आई ट्राभल युएस टु मिट अ फ्रेन्ड एन्ड अल द्याट आई सो वान्टेड एक्सप्लोर वाट द्याट कल्चर वाज बिकज ग्रोइङ अप लिसनिङ टु अमेरिकन म्युजिक एन्ड वाचिङ अल द अमेरिकन मुभिज एन्ड स्टफ लाइक द्याट आई थॉट आई वुड फिल कम्प्लिटली एट होम क्या हुन्छ नि अब वी ऑल हैव द्याट
पुगेपछि थाहा हुन्छ कि आई टेल एभ्रीबॉडी वन्स यु गेट देयर इट हिट्स यु लाइक यु हिट अ ब्रिक वॉल के
दैट्स व्हाट आई एम कमिंग टू सो मलाई चाहिँ के भने आई वाज मेबी लाइक इन माय मिड 20s वेल नो लेट 20s 30 मेबी So I reached US, you know? Boston was the first place I landed, so I stayed in Boston for a week. Traveled to New York on the bus, in the, what do you call that bus?
The blue bus, the blue collar one. I know. I just took that bus.
Tell me.
Oh, man. Oh, my God. I have the whole email of that. Hold on. We have to.
Greyhound.
Yeah.
So Greyhound, huh? So I traveled by Greyhound from Boston to New York, stayed in New York for like 10 days, explored every part of New York.
Do you remember the time you went to Times Square for the first time?
Yeah, that's the time.
Man.
That's the time. So listen,
Yeah, yeah.
There was so much newness to all of these things. Firstly, I felt completely cut off from who I was, you know, moment. Like everything is so foreign. People can't relate to me. They don't understand my sort of, I'm speaking English, but they're like, yeah, what? Like, you know. So it was a complete culture shock for me in so many ways. And I was sort of, in a way, I think, feeling deprived of certain thing. I don't know what it was. I couldn't nail it down. But I didn't feel wholeness in that. I didn't feel like satisfied with what it was. Just boom, 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 boom. And then something missing, in simple terms. Something was missing, yeah, bro. New York, my boss said, Vanguard Club, Maguire, you know, I watched jazz set, BB King Club, I watched thing. Boston, I watched the Boston Philharmonic, you know. The first time I watched a Philharmonic, this one, Yo-Yo Ma, you know. Yo-Yo Ma was, then, anyway, so from New York, I traveled to Chicago by train to meet a friend. I wouldn't travel by train, because I don't know how the train is there, eh? It was 14 hours. Anyways. So reached Chicago to meet a friend, John, stayed in his place. Then I watched the Chicago Philharmonic with Yo-Yo Ma and stuff like that. So I don't know, something's missing here, bro. I don't know what it was, but I was not very happy. Yeah, it was not like what I thought that was any. It was a sunny day in Chicago. So he said, let's go to the beach. I guess we'll go to the beach. So he took me to a beach. Not a great beach, but it was a beach nonetheless. Mm. Chicago weather also is dicey.
It
was luckily sunny in the half part of the day. So then I felt somewhat relaxed. I don't know what it was. Like, it just made me relax, wash away, whatever. I was relaxed. And suddenly a tune was hitting in my head. Suddenly, automatically. Maybe it's the pain that was inside of me just came out. It was like, salala, khola jai bagyo salala. So that thing started, so I started humming that also. I felt so much at ease when I was humming that tune and watching that scene. And it was like, just a connection. I was like, just what I was looking for type. Okay. Suddenly I felt a sense of, I relaxed back somehow. And then whatever that happened, I stayed in Chicago. came back home, and this and that thing happened. Then, I don't know, this changed me in a way that I didn't know it, you know. Mm. It was good for me in a way, yeah. I think it made me realize that I was not who I thought I was, yeah. Mm. I was naturally, the way I perceived the world was not as an American. Okay? The way I perceived the world, the things that mattered to me most, the thing that was through an eye of, through a heart of a Nepali person. Okay? You know, the way I saw the world, the way I felt it, actually. I think I felt it, I perceived the world, mm-hmm. my immediate perception, was through my mother language, through my mother, isn't it? So then it made me realize that how come I'm connecting to this, and you know, when I'm in America, I should have connected to all of this American, you know, glitz and whatever. So then it just sort of, after that was the turning point of what I started doing. Yeah? Then I started searching on my Afnik, which is, yeah, like what is immediately in front of me, what am I firstly, then I would, you know,
yeah,
let me just
find my roots
first, and then, you know, let's see if this works, you know, because before that I was trying to do everything else, but it never worked in a way. The connection was missing, yeah, somehow.
Yeah.
You got there, somehow I feel so satisfied, and so I realized that I think deep down I was just a simple person, you know, who basically I perceived things not as anybody else, but as myself, and as how I grew up to be, you know, a simple boy from a Nepali kid from Kalimpong growing up, whatever. So anyway, so I wrote Wildfire for that.
If you love what we are doing, make sure that you subscribe and turn on notifications. This episode is brought to you by Pulsar.